As part of the Progress-specific platform, OpenEdge provides an application development and deployment environment for any device using a multi-tenant enterprise database. Starting with version 11.4, error objects originating from the OpenEdge AppServer can be thrown to ABL client applications. This gives you greater flexibility in catching and handling runtime errors raised in server code. Let's take a look at some code examples that demonstrate this point. The project contains two folders to simulate the separate client and server code. The main block in client.p connects to ASBroker1 and tests to see if the connection is successful. Upon a successful connection, the code calls server.p and passes an input-output parameter named dmydate. As the comments indicate, the server.p code intentionally introduces a runtime error so that an error object will be thrown. The error object is thrown and caught in the variable PLS, which is an instance of progress.lang.sysError. The do block iterates through the messages and displays the information. Now let's look at the code in server.p. The notes comment reminds us to add the server folder as the working directory for ASBroker1. You can do this through the OpenEdge Management Console by selecting ASBroker1 from Resources, and then selecting Configuration to edit the working directory. If you make changes, you have to restart the broker before testing. The demonstration server program is very simple. It is a requirement for server code to throw an error object when an error occurs. This program displays the date to show that the date passed was valid before it assigns a very unlucky date to the output value. This assignment raises a runtime error because there is no match for month 13. The error handling throws an error object. Let's run the sample. You can see the message pulled from the returned error object. The month of a date must be from 1 to 12. In this case, the marshaling of the error object was automatic. If your code uses a subclass of progress.lang.apperror, you will need to take the additional step of marking that subclass as serializable. This completes our look at how to throw an error object. The next video in this playlist shows how to pass ABL objects between ABL clients and AppServer logic by using the serializable keyword when defining your own classes.